Hello friends, now we discuss one of the major application of laser, that is holography. It is three-dimensional photography, or we can say it is technique to obtain three-dimensional image of object. Now one question I would like to ask you. Now you know the photography. Give the two steps to obtain photograph. You may pause the video, think for some time, and write your answer. I hope you have written your answer. Now, the answer to this question is, whenever the light beam is incident on the object, it is reflected by the object, and that reflected light, it contains all the information about the object, and that reflected light is made incident on photographic plate that gives amplitude distribution, and that is nothing but the image of the object, and it has two dimensional characteristics. Now we are talking about three dimensional image, and we call it as a holography. So what is principle used here? The principle used here is the interference. So there are two beams, one is coherent beam and other is two coherent beams, one is object beam and other is reference beam. So it is based on principle of interference between object beam and reference beam. To obtain three-dimensional image, there are two steps. First step is recording of hologram. Now you can see here, we have the laser beam, and that laser beam is split into two beams. One incident on mirror, it is reflected from mirror, we call it as a reference beam. And you can see here one tree like object is shown here. The other beam, second beam, incident on object and it is scattered by the object, it is called object beam. You can see here the reference beam and object beam, they are simultaneously incident on photographic plate. So it interferes, they interfere and produce interference pattern, and you can see here interference fringes in the figure B, and that photographic plate with interference pattern is called hologram. Now this hologram, it contains amplitude as well as phase variation. Now second step in holography is reconstruction of image. Now, in place of photographic plate, we use the hologram that contains interference fringes. Now, the laser beam identical to reference beam is incident on hologram. We call it as reconstruction image, reconstruction beam. Now, this hologram containing interference fringes, it acts as a refraction grating, and this beam is diffracted by these interference fringes. Now the refracted beam, it gives two images, real image in front and virtual image behind the hologram. Observer observes virtual image and it has three dimensional characteristics. Now why holography is important? Holography has different applications and different features, very interesting features also it has. One of the most important feature, I would say that the complete hologram is not required to obtain the complete image. Due to some reason, if hologram is damaged or if it is cut into different pieces, then only 1/8 part of hologram can give complete image. And the second important feature is several images can be recorded on the same photographic plate. So this feature, we can use it as an application, as a data storage system, and one of the most engineering applications, it is the non-destructive technique to test the material. Thank you very much.